beautiful book reading, my three bookers, so and finally got to our dream. Even though it didn't work. These Amish people in front of us, we were traveling in a pretty big family. I was saying that coming from a family of eight. So, but they had a pretty little kids who were really well behaved. And it's just like, finally, good kids. Yeah, so it was just cool to experience some cultures. And then Denver, creating. Shared yesterday's story and trying to get today and it's working really well. I'm not going to
Hi, okay, so this is coming from my room in Canberra. I didn't make a video at the LAX terminal because there were a lot of people there, and I didn't want everybody staring at me, so I didn't make one, but you didn't miss anything, because the terminal was not that great. So what happened during my 5-hour wait was that I got off the plane and found my terminal, which was Terminal 77, and I double-checked on the monitor because I learned in Denver that even though it says one terminal on your ticket from one day, it could change, so always double-check. In Denver, I went to one terminal and then double-checked the monitor and tried to walk back across the airport to find another terminal. Luckily, I had more than enough time to do so. But anyway, at LAX, I found the terminal, came down on just a bunch of seats, and started reading for a while. And then I got bored, so I went and took my stuff and explored around. Was looking at my options for dinner because I was starting to get hungry. I didn't eat in Denver. I don't really eat too much when I'm traveling. I ended up eating McDonald's for dinner. It's tasty. I took my food back and went back to the same seats in front of my terminal and just ran to eat. And then after a while, my running capris and running shorts for the 14-hour flight just to be comfy, which I'm really glad I did that. It was much easier to sleep in those than the jeans would have been. Kept me pretty warm. Alright. Had a window seat, luckily, and an empty seat next to me. Then there was a man sitting in the aisle seat who was really nice. We didn't really talk too much, but never really seemed to bother him when I asked to get out to either stretch or go to the bathroom or something. Because you need to do those on those flights. It was a lot of sitting down. So I got on the plane and got to my seat and everything, and then just waited there to take off for an hour. We had a delay because there was a weight distribution problem. That's always fun. So they ended up moving some people from the back of the plane to the middle part, I guess. Yeah, it took them, I think, way too long to do that. And after we took off, I fell asleep. I was really tired. Then woke up and they served us dinner and drinks, and we watched a lot of movies. I always seemed to like fall asleep during some portion of them. Neither was the beginning or the end, so I don't think I ever watched a full movie. They also gave us like a mid-flight snack, which was a sandwich and chips, and it was pretty good. I mean, for airplane food, it was not bad. There was going to be some turbulence while you're landing, or close to it. We had to eat breakfast really fast, earlier than expected. And the crew went around and, you know, we did breakfast. Like, the whole plane did breakfast in about a half hour, which there were a good 200 or so people on the plane. But there ended up not being any turbulence when we landed. The winds were, I think, 200 miles per hour, but it didn't affect the plane at all, which I guess I'm glad about. Got off the plane and had to go through. They have two sets of customs. One, when you got off the plane and you just had your carry-on bags, and then you went and picked up your checked luggage, and then went through a second set of customs, which all in all took about an hour. It wasn't long at all. I had missed my original bus because of the delay in LA, so I had to find a place to buy a new bus ticket. A lot of questions. And everybody was really nice to help, the people that I stopped and asked. And so finally got on the bus to Canberra.
A sack of clothes, free and easy down the road I go. Hanging memories on the highline poles, free and easy down the road I go. Free and easy down the road I go. Up.
Ride, so not too bad. Got to see some community part of Sydney, which was really interesting. They have a lot of different types of architecture like within their houses, but it's pretty cool. There's definitely some Spanish influences you can tell, and I think we drove through a Muslim community. It was interesting to see.
Living life like a Sunday stroll, free and easy down the road I go. Free and easy down the road I go. If you only get to go around one time.
Welcome back, winter once again.
So I got off the bus coming from Sydney, and it was now in Canberra, and I don't think my text went through because I had a driver that was picking me up, but he wasn't there, and I called him a couple times and he wouldn't pick up, so I just went into the bus station and sat there and kept calling him and texting him, and finally he picked up and he was like, "Oh, you're there." Yay. Yeah, I am.
Just came there and picked me up in like 15 minutes and drove me there and told me a little history of Australia. And it was interesting and cool, and everybody was really nice and happy to help. So then I got to the residential office and had to wait there because they had just updated their system and it was acting up, so they couldn't grant me a pass key to get into the residence. So I waited there for probably an hour, and finally they got another guy who works there to let me in. He had a whole bag of stuff, bag of like goodies and coupons and advertisements and stuff. Took that, and the man showed me to my room and unlocked my door and everything. So then I set up and